Hello, welcome to you all in my channel in mechanical engineering concept. Today I am going to continue my previous topic, which is cylinder and sphere under internal pressure, in which I have already discussed about cylinder under internal pressure, in which I have already derived the hoop stress and hoop stress or circumferential stress and the longitudinal stress formula. Today I am going to discuss about thin sphere under internal pressure. This is the cross-section area of the sphere, in which D is the thickness of the sphere, D is the internal diameter of the sphere. Basic consideration in a sphere is the, in a thin sphere, radial stresses are always avoided or taken as a zero. Meaning the hoop stress or circumferential stress will be zero. So the sigma h will be zero. And the other longitudinal stress will be all the stress induced in the sphere due to internal pressure. In any section of a sphere, whenever we cut from anywhere in the sphere, then we come out as a stress is equal to pressure into diameter of the sphere by 4t, which is equal to the longitudinal stress of the cylindrical shell, which I have already been derived for a cylinder under pressure, in which the resisting area will be pi dt circumference into thickness, and the circular section will be pi 4 d square into pressure. So the longitudinal stress will be equal to thin sphere under pressure for stress condition. So now I'm going to discuss another topic, which is volumetric strain for a cylinder. Calculation of volumetric strain for cylinder. So as we know that stress is the change in length by origin or change in cross section by original cross section. So for whenever we need to calculate the strain for volume condition, and the volumetric strain will be equal to change in volume by original volume. Here the change in volume will be new volume minus original volume divided by old volume or original volume. So volume of cylinder will be, as we know that the basic mathematical formula for volume of cylinder, pi by 4 t square into l. T square will be the circumference section of the diameter of the cylinder, and l will be the length of the cylinder. So pi by 4 t square l will be the volume of cylinder. So due to internal pressure, the change in diameter will be d plus delta d, and change in length will be L plus delta L. So when we put this D and L, new D and L value in the new volume, then the volume will be come out as V dash is equal to pi 4 D plus delta D square into L plus delta L. So when we simplify our volumetric strain, V dash plus V divided by V, change in volume by original volume, and putting that new volume and original volume value that equation, then we see that pi 4 will be the common in numerator and denominator both end. So taking as a common value pi 4 and cancel it out from numerator and denominator both terms, then the equation will come out as a d plus delta d square l plus delta l minus d square l by d square l. Simplifying this d plus delta d square, or opening this bracket and multiplying this term, this to that, L plus delta L, then our term will come out as this one. Cancel it out, plus a negative and positive values both end, and taking 2D delta D del L as a negligible value, because delta D and delta L will be a very small value. So this can be neglected. Then the volumetric strain will come out as EV is equal to d square delta L plus 2d delta d L by d square L. Simplifying or separating both the terms from positive end, d square delta L by d square L plus 2d delta d L by d square L. D square will be cancelled out from this term, and d square and d will be cancelled out from this, and L will be cancelled out. As a result, the volumetric strain will come out as a delta L by L plus 2d delta d by delta L, delta d by d. So we know that change in length by original length, this is the term, change in length by original. This is the longitudinal strain condition, and change in diameter by original diameter. This is the circumferential strain. So we can write it, volumetric strain is equal to longitudinal strain plus 2 times of hoop stress for hoop strain plus hoop strain for circumferential strain. So for cylinder condition, cylinder or the volumetric strain will be written as longitudinal strain is a sum of longitudinal strain plus 2 times of hoop strain for circumferential strain. I hope you like this video and all of you understand all the basic concepts related to secondary sphere. If you want to query about this video, then please tell me below the comment section below this video, and don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thank you.